Just really thrilled that you guys are doing this for these bands that probably will never get into Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
I know, right?
Stupid.
I
just finished 25 years with Steppenwolf. I was telling him, and we're not in the Hall of Fame. John Kay is not in the Hall.
Wait, how is Steppenwolf not in the Hall of Fame? That's actually, I forgot about that.
Maybe I should tell him about this.
Yeah, I know. We'll have to say something about that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But Steppenwolf really should be. They are a forerunner of so much.
Yeah, I'm really thrilled that you guys are doing this because a lot of the you know, metal, people thought it was going to be a fad, but it's still around.
Yeah.
And the people like Ozzy, they probably won't put him in the Hall of Fame, but I really think this is going to be good.
Yeah. And, you know, funny enough, Steppenwolf actually, I think, coined the term heavy metal and heavy metal thunder, right?
You're right.
Yeah. So, I mean, they should be in just for that.
Yeah, yeah.
And they should be, actually, we should put them in this.
Well, the song did make it as the first song. It the category was the most influential song in history. And I was thrilled, but it didn't really...
Yeah.
You know, a song. I mean, come on, give it up.
Yeah. The band should be in, definitely.
I mean, when you see doo-wop bands, and I'm from Louisiana. I love soul music, but that's not rock and roll.
It's not rock and roll.
Yeah.
Agreed. Yeah, you know, we could go on all day about the slights of the so-called Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And this year's crop, you know, is hit and miss. Nine Inch Nails, okay, great. Yeah. Do they deserve to be in Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? I think so.
Yeah.
But why isn't Motorhead in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Why isn't Judas fucking Priest in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Why?
You know, I mean, let's be real about these things.
Yeah.
Now, they put T-Rex in, another great influential band, but the MC5 got passed on. Todd Rundgren got passed on. You know, all these guys who are very important to the foundation of what rock and pop music is nowadays. So, so Steppenwolf should be in there. Now, Alcatraz, of course, we love Graham Bonnet. Great man. Love him. He's been on our show a number of times. Wish he'd be here right now, because we've had him on the show, but it's been a while since we've seen him.
Yeah, it's hard to pin him down.
I know.
Remember that about him.
He's a bundle of energy, this guy, now. So, are you working on anything else yourself?
Well, I've been doing some solo stuff, and Guitar World magazine just did a 4-page feature story on me a couple months back, and I was real pleased with that. I'm pretty blessed, you know. I still work with Carmine Appice, and I'm going to do some stuff Saturday night here with some all-star stuff. I'm not supposed to talk about it, but it'll come out.
By the time this airs, it'll be old news.
Yeah. Well, what magazines are...
This is Reality Check TV.
Okay, I love
Carmine's
it.
Carmine's been on it. Graham Bonnet's been on it.
Do you have a card?
I do.
We'll exchange
cards. So where do people go to find out more about your stuff?
Huh?
Social media, where do people go to find out more about your stuff?
Well, to my website or Facebook, DannyJohnsonDJ.com.
Spell that for the boys and girls.
DannyJohnsonDJ.com, DannyJohnsonDJ.com.
There you go. So go check all that stuff out and find out more about this guy who's played with many amazing greats in the rock
world. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's an honor.